That's right, Jen, from IT to tourism to healthcare, Claremont says it's ready to become a hub of business here in New Hampshire. And the city has managed to weather the economic storm better than most, but that's also why the governor brought his jobs team to Claremont to ensure the city doesn't lose the momentum.
Can Sim deliver that quickly?
As a young professional, Heather Irish could have bolted out of Claremont years ago, but she didn't. And here's why.
The potential is the best way to put it, the potential.
While many New Hampshire towns are struggling, Claremont seems to have turned a corner. The $40 million mill renovation project downtown is now spawning shops and restaurants. The hospital is going through a $20 million rehabilitation, and unemployment here is well below the state average. And nestled in an aesthetically pleasing countryside along the Connecticut River near the Vermont border, city planners feel the stars are now aligned.
We think that some of the industry in the Upper Valley, particularly that since Lebanon is booming up there and tight at the seams, will welcome them down here into Claremont.
You were forced, and you didn't want to do this.
But potential has a funny way of often going unrealized, and that's why Tuesday the governor brought his jobs cabinet to Claremont to offer whatever assistance the state can provide.
So our goal today in Claremont is to listen to the business people who actually create the jobs as to how we can better help them in a partnership moving forward.
There are kind of little incentive packages, ways that we can assist with financing, job training. There are a number of things that we can do to help put the package together in combination with what the city of Claremont is offering so that a company can look at this and say, boy, this is a great place.
That's exactly what happened when Red River Computer Company moved its headquarters to Claremont last year. Red River now employs 65 people, including Heather Irish, and she loves it, both the job and the city.
Absolutely. Would never leave.
This isn't the first time the governor's job cabinet has held these kinds of discussions. In fact, meetings with business leaders in the past has spawned the job match page on the Employment Security's website, as well as the New Hampshire Health First program. The next roundtable is scheduled for October 8th in Laconia. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.